Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is on this look right here, kind of a trick how to get some wing eyeliner, bring it a little in the middle to elongate your eye. I've also got some first impressions of the new Stay Vulnerable collection from the Rare Beauty brand. This is Selena Gomez's makeup line. I really enjoy it. I think it's super affordable, and I'm going to give you some first impressions and kind of how I had to work with some of her products. I try out her new liquid and cream or liquid eyeshadows and her eyeliner. I've already used her blush before, and you guys know that I love it, as well as her highlight and her chapstick, but I swatched some new colors for you guys to see. Let me know if you would like this. Would you buy it? Do you want to wear it? Let me know down below. So if you could just hit that like and subscribe button, that would definitely hit my channel a lot. Get me out there, get me popular, make me famous, and share it with your friends. Hope you guys enjoy this tutorial, and I will get to it. I'll just shut up. Okay, goodbye. Okay, I'm really excited about today's look because I get to try out some of Rare Beauty's brand new Stay Vulnerable collection, which are these two liquid cream eyeshadows that I have. And then I bought new chapstick tints. I'm going to swatch them and let you guys see them on. And I also got her eyeliner, which I'm super excited to try. Shake it. And so I'm going to start with my eyes first this video, because I'm going to show you guys a trick to do wing eyeliner, because I'm not very good at it. Still practicing to this day, but I'm going to show you a trick. If you see this redness right here, it's because I just got done blacking, okay? So just ignore it, okay? So I'm going to use the Viseart eye primer. I got this in my BoxyCharm box. If you haven't signed up for BoxyCharm, I would, because I'm getting some good stuff in my boxes. Okay, so I got two colors. I got this nearly neutral shade, which is kind of like a neutral, and then I've got this nearly berry, and honestly, like, I'm a little excited. I think I'm gonna do one on each eye to try it out. I feel like this will make a great Valentine's Day look, and this is just like every day. I mean, it's not just Valentine's Day, but you know what I mean. So I've watched videos on how to apply this. It comes in like a doe foot applicator. Kind of show you, it's kind of an interesting little doe foot there. Oh, I have something on my hand. There. And they literally just paint it on, and then you can either use your finger or a brush to kind of like blend it out. It's supposed to go on as a cream and then kind of like finish into like a powder effect. So I'm gonna, we're gonna do one eye on each color, and then I want you guys to tell me what you think looks best. So first I'm gonna go in with this nearly berry color. Okay, then I'm gonna take kind of like a fluffier brush and just blend it out. Okay, so this is a first impressions video. I have not used these yet. I took it a little too high for my liking, but it did blend out, I feel like, really well. I just don't think I did a good enough line, but I feel like this is going to take some practice with it a little bit. I think I'm going to add a little bit more on the lid, make that a little darker, and kind of go into like a lighter. It definitely sheers out. Okay, so this is the first eye done with Nearly Berry. I really like that color. This is going to take some playing around with. So this is the nearly neutral color. I'm going to do it on this eye. So I think for this, I'm going to use my eyeshadow brush that I normally use to see if that kind of helps me blend it out a little bit better, but we'll see. Can't tell if that's the discoloration on my eyelid or if that's the shadow. I think it's my eyelid. Okay, I think that blended out a lot better, and it kind of makes me want to take this eye off and try it again with the more dense, fluffier brush. You know what? I'm going to try it out with a concealer primer. I'm going to take this off and try it out with a concealer primer because I'm having a hard issue with it's so sheer, and that's what she wants. Like, Selena, this is Selena Gomez's brand of Rare Beauty, and she really wants to, like, enhance your natural skin. But I just feel like I've got, like, I mean, I have dark circles sometimes and veins and stuff, and I feel like it's so sheer you can see right through it and you can see that. So I'm going to try using my concealer as my primer. Okay, so I'm gonna try it out with my shape tape, and I mean, this is, I'm not going anywhere. It's literally 8:30 at night right now. I'm just trying to play around in makeup right now. So, but me using this, you know, can help somebody else out and figure out what they, how they want to use this, and so on. Okay. And I'm also going to go ahead and start off with my winged eyeliner trick because I felt like, too, it was getting a little messy with my outer corner. So, to do this winged eyeliner, I take just regular Scotch tape. And I'm going to take a little piece of tape. And what you want to do first is kind of stick it to the back of your hand and then rip it off and kind of do that a couple of times. Because that gets like the real bad sticky that's gonna like hurt your eyes as you take it off. So kind of do that a couple times. And then what I like to do is I take it and I line it up with however, like the line that I want my wing eyeliner to look like. And I like for it to be a little bit more sideways than pointed up. So I'm just gonna kind of line it the way that I would like to. Sometimes it takes me a few times to figure out the placement, but that's about where I want to be at. I know I look like a crazy person, but you'll thank me later. Doing this tape trick as well kind of helps you to see, like, because this eye, I get my wing eyeliner by without the tape perfect, and this eye, so I like, I just, I don't know, at this eye I get the right angle that I like, and this eye I'm always like way far up. So this kind of helps me to be able to get them even, and it's kind of just makes it a sharp, nice line. It's really good. So okay, so I think I finally got it where I want it to sit. I mean, it takes a couple tries, you know, don't worry about it. Okay, so now that we've kind of let that concealer sit a little bit, I'm going to go back in with Nearly Barely Berry and Nearly Neutral. But I'm going to use a brush this time. Okay, I don't know what y'all think, but I think that went on way better. I even kind of like that color payout a little bit more. I again think I'm gonna add just a tiny bit more to the lid though. So now I'm gonna go in with Newly Neutral. Why can't I say these names right? Nearly Neutral. Okay, I like that so much better. I feel like sometimes you just need kind of like that base on your eyes just to kind of make it like a neutral, like neutralize all your redness, your veins, your dark circles. And I just really feel like that definitely helped a lot. And I really, because at first I was kind of like, I don't know if I like this. I don't know if I like these colors. It wasn't turning out like these people's videos that I watched. So I'm really glad that I did that concealer and I like that a whole lot better now. So I'm gonna go in with my Tartelette Little Toasty and get this Flicker out. I like to put this right here. And honestly, I think if you used a color that's like a tad lighter than your skin tone, this would be perfect just because I feel like it gives that little brightness underneath the eye that kind of you need to like just fix up that look. Okay, now for the eyeliner. I'm so excited for this part and I'm gonna mess up my eyeliner, don't you worry. But this is the Rare Beauty eyeliner. It's Perfect Strokes Matte Liquid Liner. It is black, and if you listen to it, you can hear a little ball in there. You need to do that anytime you hear that in your makeup because it just kind of helps mix up that color and get it perfect. So, I don't know if you can see this, but it's a bunch of tiny little bristles put together to kind of make it look like it's a felt tip, but it's actually a bunch of little bristles. So, really cute. So, now, this is the scary part. This is the part where you just don't breathe, but I'm going to kind of, try to decide where I want to start. Started up. So I'll just kind of start a little bit past. Hang on, guys, I need to do this in the mirror, but I'll still make sure I'm where you guys can see. She's definitely pigmented, I can tell you that. And I think what I'm gonna try to do too is like go in and create that little look just to elongate it a little bit. Okay, so I don't know if you can tell, but I messed up a little bit right there. So I'm going to take my pad and kind of my wipe the main on my pad. The point like so. So I don't know, I think that turned out pretty good. I'm going to do the other eye. Okay. I don't know if you guys notice how red I am. First of all, it's hot underneath all of these lights. But also, this right here is so stressful and like I do it a million times. That's the thing about doing this look before you do your face makeup is because you can sit there and wipe and redo. So I'm finally satisfied with that. So now I just kind of like make sure that I feel like it looks like my wings are about the same
width.
Now let's take them off and see how they look. And then you can kind of see, like, right here on my tail, right here, it's not... There, that looks a little bit better. You know what? We're just gonna go with it, okay? We're gonna go with it. And remember what I told you? Remember what I told you? I'm not good at my wing eyeliner. I'm still practicing, but that definitely, like, helps me a lot. I mean, I feel like you can definitely tell. Oh, well, we're learning. We're gonna do this together, okay? So, I'm pretty much done with the eyes besides mascara, but I feel like I need to do that last, so I'm gonna go ahead and do my face, and I'll be right back. If I give you every piece of me, I know that you could drop it. Give you the chance, I know that you could take advantage, but you got it. If I open my heart to you, I know that you could lock it. Throw away the key, keep it there forever in your pocket. If I give the opportunity to you, then would you blow it? If I was the greatest thing to happen to you, would you know it? If my love was like a flower, would you plant it, would you grow it? I'ma give you all my body, are you strong enough to hold it? If I show you all my demons and we dive into the deep, and would we crash and burn? I'll stay vulnerable. Yeah. I'll stay vulnerable. Yeah. I'll stay vulnerable. If I hand you my emotions, would you even wanna take it?
Would you even wanna take it? Yeah.
If I give you all my trust, then would you fumble it and break it? Mm-hmm. If I let you cross my finish line, then would you wanna make it? I'll stay vulnerable.
massacre, and no war and anger was ever won. Put out the fire before igniting. Next time you're fighting,
and that is it for the face. I'm really liking how these eyes look. I don't know which color I like better. What do you guys think? Do you like the nearly neutral or the nearly berry? Also, I don't know what happened, but I think I got concealer in my eye, so I think that's why it's turning a little red there, so just ignore that. But I did tell you guys that I was going to go ahead and swatch the two tinted chapsticks I got from Rare Beauty. I got the colors Blessed and Praise. So I'm going to go start with Praise first. I'm going to start with Blessed first. This is a real pinky pink. I think this is going to be so fun for the summertime. Okay, it's definitely a bold pink. Doesn't go with this look, but I just wanted to show you guys what it looked like. I think it's gonna be so fun for summer. So now, I'm gonna go in with the color Praise. This is more of like a peachy nude. This is Praise. I still think it's a little bit bright. It might be better for springtime, more like fun color summer. So, okay, let's just start from the beginning. So, for the Stay Vulnerable Rare Beauty eyeshadow collection. So, at first, I did not like it with just my clear eyeshadow Viseart eye primer. I really felt like it showed like my true skin colors underneath it, which when you watch the interviews that Selena Gomez does about these, her makeup line, she talks about she wants it to show your true skin but enhance it. Well, I don't really want to enhance my veins and my dark circles, so I really didn't like it before I put on my Shape Tape. I don't know why I want to keep calling it Sharp. What's wrong with me? My Shape Tape concealer, and I used that for my eyeshadow primer, and I really liked the payoff color that it gave better for both colors, and I feel like it just looks blended more and more smooth when I used it, and I really liked it with my, I thought at first I was going to use like a more loose brush just because it is a liquid, but I really liked it with my more dense brush that I normally use. So I definitely would recommend using more of like a full coverage kind of eye primer to kind of get rid of your and neutralize your skin tone. And I really did like both of these colors. I can really see using the Nearly Berry as more, you know, romantic date night look, and it's Nearly Neutral. It's like everyday, do what you want kind of look. Okay, Rare Beauty's eyeliner. I did like this. It felt super weird when I was using it because I'm used to felt tips when they look like this, and it's bristles. So it's kind of weird. I mean, I'm definitely gonna use it again. And I think it was great. I mean, I think that I was able to get like even my line sharp, and I feel like it's definitely very pigmented. But I really like this. Would I buy it again? I feel like probably no, because I feel like I can buy or get this. I don't know. I feel like I can get it something else. It's not anything new. It's just a regular eyeliner for me. With the liquid eyeshadows, would I buy these again? I think so. And I think I would like to get more colors with this because I just really like that look. And honestly, like, it's one color and I feel like it looks, I don't know. I just feel like it looks really good. I mean, that monochromatic look is coming back. You know what I mean? With the Rare Beauty blush, this is the full size. I had it in just a mini travel size, and this is the full size. It's definitely very pigmented. Be careful when you're using it. It's got this cool little doe foot applicator on it as well. It's kind of got like a flat side. And I just did two dots and I honestly felt like it was too much on my cheek. So you kind of see me go back with my beauty blender that has my concealer left over, and I kind of like pounced it out to kind of neutralize that a little bit. But I would definitely recommend these. When it comes to their chapsticks, you guys know that I already love these. Okay, they're so smooth. They're so like shea butter. I know it's like an ingredient that's used in them, and that's what they feel like. Like when I think of a chapstick or like a lotion, I think of shea butter. And now for the color, I do have to reapply it throughout the day. I'm not gonna lie, that kind of sucks, but I mean, it's a chapstick, you know, like it's not a lipstick. It's not like I'm having to like reapply a lipstick color. So I would definitely recommend these. And I think these are great during the winter time when like your lips are super dry. So you don't want to be putting lipsticks on them that kind of dry them out, but you want to have something that's got color and will keep them moisturized. As for Rare Beauty's highlight, I have the color Enchant. It's definitely more of a natural highlight. You can just kind of see it kind of gives like a healthy glow, and I have found that I actually like it better putting it on with my fingers than my beauty sponge. And I just feel like that kind of the sponge kind of like absorbs the shine a little bit in it. And when I do it with my fingers, you can kind of see that glow a little bit more. And I definitely think this is a buildable highlight. And I just did one layer and kind of see that. So that's everything. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that I inspired you to try out Rare Beauty's brand. This is Selena Gomez's brand. When you check out, you have an option to donate to a mental health organization. She's very big on that, as well as I am. So you can donate like as little as $5, and it helps go to this organization. But I mean, I would definitely recommend this brand. It's definitely affordable. Again, let me know which color you like better. Do you think that you would buy this? Do you want to wear it? Let me know. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next video. Okay, so start off again. Hey. Lipstick. I'm gonna start that all over again because I hate it.